These teachers from around the KC Metro spent their summer watching television and movies. This might sound like a slacker's dream class, but these educators are serious about taking a hard look at their profession through a new lens.
My name is Erin Gruel.
Chemistry is the study of
voodoo economics.
No more excuses.
And just give up!
Throughout the summer, we discuss films, television, music videos, commercials, short films, news stories.
University of St. Mary's professor Carolyn Doolittle has been teaching a class on media portrayals of teachers for several years, but this summer was the first time the course was offered to practicing educators like Reed Youthy.
I find myself, when I watch those movies and TV shows, thinking that's not really how it is. And this class really helped me focus in on, well, really, what are the messages that are coming across? And it was pretty eye-opening for me.
Gentlemen, open your texts.
From superstar teachers like Robin Williams, John Keating, and Dead Poets Society, to the downright despicable, like Cameron Diaz's character in Bad Teacher, educator portrayals on the screen tend towards the extreme.
The teachers were somewhat frustrated that the public perception is that there are all kinds of problems in every school. And, education is just going to hell in the handbasket.
No.
No, you ain't talking to me.
Wake up this morning, how are you?
And then they'll see how these stereotypes have affected the way people view them as teachers and affected the profession.
Real-world examples of attitudes towards educators were also part of the class.
Make it easier to fire ineffective teachers.
Like the battle over teacher tenure and due process.
The attacks on teachers and education in general was part of our discussion this summer, and trying to, you know, kind of explore where that's coming from, what we can do to get the word out that we're not some evil people that are going to ruin their children's lives, that we're in it because we love their kids and we're in it because we want to, you know, to make their children reach the highest potential they can.
You are a big, fat, stupid, zero fatty.
But it seems it's not just the portrayals of teachers that are incompetent or downright mean that create problems. It's also the superstar teachers.
One of the themes that I found that my students picked up on is that in order to be a good teacher, you have to be a super teacher. And they wonder if that's what the public perception is. That the teacher who's steady, who comes in, does their job, can't possibly be a good teacher because, my gosh, they're not living at the school, they're not there every weekend, they actually have a life of their own.
A movie wraps it up in a neat little box. And at the very end, they say, what happened 10 years later? Well, a teacher doesn't always get to see what the student turns into 10 years later.
Beginning with Blackboard Jungle in 1955, most teacher genre films depict the new and inexperienced teacher as the one that makes the biggest difference.
These teachers that were coming in just off the street and being able to teach, that's really what's happening in society now, with teacher certification kind of being pushed aside, saying that, you know, if you've spent some time in a profession, you can come in and teach it without having the pedagogy classes, the discipline, all those different things. So that made a real connection for me on how that's happening in the real world, and how maybe it's been the movies and things that have affected that idea that anybody can come in and teach.
This is Mr. Kimball, your new kindergarten teacher.
If it seems hard to swallow that these films impact, or at least reflect, overarching attitudes towards education, it's worth noting how movies and TV shows in other countries depict teachers.
La classe, c'est un lieu, un endroit d'amitié, de travail, de tenue, un lieu où il y a la vie.
The respect for the teacher is much greater in foreign schools, even in media, even through film, that the teachers that were being portrayed were very respected by their students. And the opposite seems to be true in the American classroom, where even in teacher movies and school movies, the teachers are not very well respected.
I'm not late, I'm absent.
In addition to developing a more critical eye for media depictions of educators, teachers in Doolittle's class still found inspiration in the stories on the screen.
Every teacher in the movies had a story. The students all had stories. That's the one thing that's really not different about life, is that all of us have a story. Every teacher has their own story. Every student has their own story. And I think, if anything, that I'm going to be more aware of trying to find out what my student's story is and to let them know what my story is and why I do what I do.
Reporting on education for the Hale Center for Journalism with photographer John McGrath, Lindsay Fote.